Shalom. Once again, I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As we continue to listen to the voice of God, as we continue to seek the face of God for this season which we are in now. As the Church of God, families, and our nation, God is the author. He is the one who began the seasons. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Lord records seed time and harvest time, cold and heat. All those are seasons. And every season has a purpose. And now the time and the season we are, as a nation of Kenya, and we as a church, we have to come together and reason together, because this is a command from our Lord. James chapter 5 verse 13. Is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is anyone cheerful? Let him sing psalms. Is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sin, he will be forgiven. Confess your trespasses to one another. Pray for one another that you may be healed. The effective, perfect prayer of a righteous man abides much. Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, and he prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and it did not rain on the land for 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth produced its fruits. Father, we thank you and we bless you. Your word is a seed into our hearts. Your word, Lord, leads us. Your word enlightens our spirit. Thank you for everyone who is listening. Thank you for everyone who is seeking your face in this season. In Jesus' name, we pray and believe. Amen. This word came from the mouth of the Lord, because the word of God is the mind of God. He speaks with us as his children. He tells us what to do through his word. And here comes the word that, because it came as a question, is there anyone? Because I'm in our midst, in our homes, in our churches, and in our nation, this word is a word of a season. We have people who are suffering among us. Among us in our families, among us in our nation, among us in this world, because of all of us, we are experiencing this fear. And because of that, the answer is in prayer. The answer is with our Father. We have many things. We have many questions. But Jesus, he has an answer. That's why he told the church, let not your heart be troubled. Because he knew a time for the hearts of the men, for the hearts of the people, a time will come when they will have worry. But he prepared our hearts for not to worry for anything, because he is working to prepare a place for us. And he will come for us. He will come for us from this world. That is why we are not going to hurt as his children. And because of that, the word tells us and asks us, is there anyone? If there is anyone in our midst, he tells us, pray. If you are sick, pray. If you are happy or rejoicing or careful, because you are cheerful, sing songs of praise. Why sing songs of praise? Because we tell the Lord, thank you, because of thus far you have taken me. I thank you, Lord, because you have blessed me. With good health, I thank you, Lord. With good family, I thank you, Lord. Because of our nation, I thank you, Lord. And I say, I praise you because of your faithfulness. But when one is sick, a command is, we pray and call the elders of the church to pray for us. Who are the elders of the church? Pastors are the elders of the church. And the pastors are being waited by the world. The world is in need of this word. Our nation is in need of prayer. And I speak now with the servants of God. It is a time and a season now to arise and voice out and cry unto our Father, I thank you, because we have a watch time table of prayer, which everyone is now standing at his own hour to pray and cry for this nation. We thank God because we are not going to sleep. 24/7 prayer chain, which we are offering every moment now and every time. We say like David, I will sleep as a sparrow. At night I am awake in my couch. As we sleep awake, half sleep, half awake, because we want to call upon the name of the Lord because of our beloved nation. Church, pastors are needed in every situation. Pastors are supposed to be called. And that is why we need an office of a pastor. As I cry to our leaders, as I request our leaders to allow the pastoral team, the office of a pastor, to operate, even if he's operating alone in the house of God, to keep the fire burning on the altar, to pray for those who are suffering, when they be brought to the church, he can pray for them, even keeping the directives, keeping distance. When he speaks a word, he will raise the faith of that one who is suffering. Those who are in the hospitals, even if he's not going to feast them in the hospital, he will lift up his pawn in his office, because they know the pastor is watching over them. Bible tells us, keep watch over yourself. as you keep watch of every flock that the Holy Spirit has brought under your care. Servants of God, as we keep watch of ourselves, we are keeping watch over the flock. Though this is my cry, this is my prayer, that our leaders of this nation are going to permit the office of a pastor, office of a bishop, office of an evangelist, office of a teacher to operate so that they can pray for the church with the freedom. And I know, because we are a praying nation, God is going to make a way. This moment of time, the Bible has recorded the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. The prayer, the effective prayer, fervent prayer of a righteous man releases healing upon the nation, releases healing upon the people. Ezekiel records in 22, verse 30. God is looking for a man to stand in the gap. I thank God for those who have gone in prayer, those who are praying and fasting for this nation, those who are praying and fasting for the church of God. Let us join our faith, because we are not going to lose the people of our nation. Because God commands us, and He commands for the elders to be called to pray for the sick. Yes, we are not going to have time to go and anoint them with the oil, but the word of God carries the anointing. In the beginning there was a word. The word was with God. The word was God. When we speak the word of God, we declare the power of God upon the lives of His beloved ones. So the word of God in this season is needed more than any other time, so that the church of God can be strong. Yes, we are in our homes through the directives of our government. They love us, and that is why they don't want to lose us. As we continue to quarantine, let us be on our knees. Let us use our softwares. Let us communicate. Let us give thanks to the Lord in every time. He records about Elijah. He was a man like us. He prayed for the rain, for not to rain for 3 and 6 months. And God heard his prayer. He released, He answered him. 3.5 years, there was no rain in the land of Israel until by his word. Let me tell you, church, that word, the world is waiting for that word. The word is waiting for the word that we are going to release. That word releases healing. Psalms 107 verse 20 says, I send my word and my word in thee. Hear me. His God is not going to speak you as a servant of God. The world is waiting that word. And I pray that the word of every servant of God is going to release hope in the hearts of the children of God. Let us join our faith in unity. For he records in Psalms 133 the prayer, hallelujah. When brethren come together in unity, there God commands blessings. In everywhere you are, in every place where you are, let us pray together. Let us bring the unity of the Spirit. And God is waiting to answer us. I thank God because I know all of us, we are praying for the beloved ones who are in the hospitals, for the people who have been left by their beloved ones. Almighty God is able to bless us through His love. God is waiting to overshadow us by His grace. In this time, let us pray for the minister of health. It is not easy for him, standing every time and every moment to caution us as a nation. Let us pray for our president and his leadership, because he's there holding his nation as a father of the nation, because we are lifting our eyes to see him, to see what he's waiting to do for tomorrow. And in this time, I know God has an answer. The word tells us, Psalms 127, verse 1. Unless the Lord builds the house, we labor in vain. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. We honor you this moment of time. We pray that our Father, you are going to hear our humble cry this moment of time. Because we are crying unto you, Lord. Our help comes from you. You are the one who has an answer for this nation and for the nations of this world. Because the whole world is crying unto you. Even those who doesn't know you as Lord and Savior, they know that there is a Creator who created the universe, the heart and the heaven. And we pray that, Lord, as we plead the blood of Jesus of our lives and beloved ones, of our nation, O Lord Almighty, the boundaries of this nation. And Lord, we join our faith in a global way to intercede because of this disease which has released pain in the hearts of your children. I thank you, my Father, because you hear me when I pray. Everything is in your hands. And I pray that, Lord, remember mercy. Remember mercy. Even the same sin, I pray that you are going to forgive us. Forgive the leadership of this nation. Forgive your people, my Lord, because we are called by your name. And Lord, we have turned around, we have turned unto you in prayer, in repentance. Lord, hear us and heal us. Heal our nation. Heal our nation. We are standing in the gap for our nation. Heal our nation. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. We sing a song of praise so that you can encourage our hearts. Oh, Lord, I pray for all intercessors of this nation, because I know they are crying unto you. The servants of God, bishops and the pastors and every office, fivefold ministries, I pray that you are going to encourage your children through your Spirit. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Bless us. In Jesus' name, we pray and we believe. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Thank you. God bless you.